Hello everybody, it's Marielle from AquaMermaid, and today I will teach you 10 tips how to hold your breath longer. I'm a professional mermaid and I do shows, underwater, perform, and I need to hold my breath for a long time. Before starting, make sure to always have a friend with you to practice. And our main goal is to minimize the energy that you use and maximize your relaxation state underwater.
We don't have a breath holding muscle that we can practice. Mainly, we just need to make sure our body feels more comfortable having more CO2. When you hold your breath, there is a CO2 buildup, and your body sends you signals that you need to breathe, but mainly you still have some oxygen inside you that you can use. And this is how you need to train your body to recognize those signals and get used to it, even if it's not comfortable, but you can go through it and stay longer underwater. And here are my tips to make it happen.
Number one, don't eat before going in the water for a breath hold, because digesting takes a lot of energy. I would suggest to wait at least 2 or 3 hours before going in the water. Number two, practice in the morning right after waking up, because your body will still be a bit sleepy, slow down, your heart rate is really low when you sleep, and it's a good time to practice. Tip number three, stretch before doing your breath hold. You want to stretch everything around your torso, your diaphragm, your belly. You can do some side stretching, big breath, inhale and exhale, just to make sure that all the space in your lungs knows how to stretch and take as much space for the air to come in your body. Number four, wear a diving mask. Not only goggles, you need to wear a diving mask first because the water won't go in your eyes or in your nose, can be distracting, but also if you go deep, you will be able to equalize, because when you go deep in the water, there's a lot of pressure and goggles will squeeze on your face. With a mask, you can blow a bit of air through your nose to make sure it's not squeezing too much on your face. It will be much more comfortable. You will feel the feeling of squeezing on your face if you go dive more than 1 or 2 meters in the water. Number five, use a wetsuit. To minimize the energy that you use, you need to feel warm. If you're cold, your body is gonna fight to warm you up and it's gonna take a lot of energy. Number six, if you want to hold your breath for a long time, you need to warm up your lungs. This means you can use some breath holding tables to get your lungs warmed up and ready to hold your breath for a long time. Then mainly what you do is that you start with the short time that you hold your breath and increase slowly. You can increase by 15 seconds, by 30 seconds, according how you feel. Then how I do it myself, I find a relaxing spot and then I hold my breath to start with 1 minute. 1 minute, and then I take a 2 minute break, just breathing normally, relaxing. And then I do it again, 1 minute 30. And then I relax, I took 2 minutes break, and I do up to 2 minutes. After those breathing tables, I'm ready to start with my longest breath hold. You can practice those breath hold tables on land or in the water as you wish, and just make sure to be relaxed and take a good break in between. 2 minutes should be good. And also if you're more beginner, you can start at 30 seconds, increase to 45 seconds and up to 1 minute, and you will slowly increase that way. But it's good to, your body will start feeling the symptoms of how you need some air and you have more CO2 in your body.
When you take your inhale and exhale, your exhale should be always twice as long as your inhale. And also to make it slower, I do the sound like a snake. I do like, this is the sound I make. That way I make sure, I just like pinch my tongue to make sure the air is really going slowly and I hear it too.
Number seven, when you're ready to do your big breath hold, you need to breathe 3 times, take a big inhale, and take double the time to exhale. You do that 3 times, and then you take a super big inhale, make sure your lungs are filled, your belly's lifting up, and you go underwater and hold your breath as long as possible. Make sure to not hyperventilate. This means to breathe fast, inhale, like this, because this will make your body not give you the signal when you need to come back for air. And it can be dangerous, you can pass out, black out underwater, and it can lead to drowning.
When you take a deep breath, there's more oxygen that are going in your cell, and that helps you to stay longer underwater. Also, make sure to don't keep any air in your cheeks like this.
Tip number eight, you can do static breath holding. If you don't move, you're gonna save some energy and you will be able to stay longer underwater.
Doing static breath holding will allow you to stay longer underwater because you're using less energy. But if you want to swim underwater and move around, you will need to practice breath holding while swimming. What you need to balance is between how much effort do you use to move and swim compared to how long you want to stay and being relaxed. Then you need to find a steady speed that is good in your moving, but not rush too fast to use all your energy at once. Then mainly, you're balancing the effort and the speed that you're using. You want to get as quickly as possible to the other side of the pool, but without using all your energy and pumping your heart so fast that when you get there, you need to have a super long breathe up to bring back your heart rate lower. Number 9, use a weight belt or any weight to keep you at the bottom of the pool. If you're always floating up, you will be fighting to sink down, and also that will use a lot of energy that you could use to stay longer underwater. Tip number 10, do not blow bubbles before you come back up, because you want to keep all the oxygen and air possible inside your body. At one point, you will start feeling the urge to come back up for air, but mainly you still have air in your body. You just have too much CO2 and your body is fighting this, and you will feel some contraction in your belly. Control this panic and distress and just say, it's okay, I can stay here longer. It's a mental fight. When you blow bubbles out, you will feel better because you have less CO2 in your body, but mainly you will have less oxygen that you would have been able to use. And really important, do not blow out bubbles before you come back up. I have 3 bonus tips for you to hold your breath longer. Then number 11 is to stay at the surface of the water instead of going deeper, because the deeper you go, the more air you will use. Tips number 12 is, before your breath holding, put water in your face. I would even suggest to just hold your breath for 30 seconds, your face in the water without anything, no mask, no goggles, just to make sure that your face touched the water. This will trigger the mammalian diver reflex. Mainly, it's a reflex that your body has when it's immersed in the water. When you have water in your face, your heart rate will slow down by 10 to 20% when you're in the water. And that's really helpful because you can hold your breath longer. And that results in using less oxygen. If you train a lot, this reflex will get stronger and you will be able to slow down your heart rate even more. But this is something you cannot really control. It's just a reflex from your body that all the mammalians have been doing for many, many years. You can practice breath holding outside of the water or in the water, but doing it in the water will be easier to hold your breath longer, because I feel when you're floating, you feel like one with the water, you feel more comfortable and you can really relax more. Tips number 13, a few ways how you can increase your performances is doing some cardio exercise. Practicing cardio exercises will help you lower your resting heart rate, and that way you're more efficient when you're underwater. Also, practicing singing or any music instrument, air music instrument, will really help you control your breathing and be more comfortable with your breath. Also, losing weight will be helpful to have a longer breath hold underwater. That's it for this video. I hope it helps. Let me know if I forgot any tips or anything you would like to know. Let me also in the comment below, how long can you hold your breath? Maybe before this video and after this video, if you see a big difference. Make sure to subscribe, give me a thumbs up, and I will see you in my next video for more swimming and mermaid tutorial. See you. Bye.